to the surprise of almost no one who follows Apple. The company is planning to hold a big event early in September to take the ramps off its next iPhone. According to the well-sourced John Patchkowski of BuzzIrond, that event will happen on Wednesday, September 9. iPhones are a shoe-in, as they've been introduced in this time frame every year since 2011. But BuzzIrond also claims we'll see some new iPads as well as the long-awaited new Apple TV. The latter was originally rumored to be introduced at WWDC this year, but it was nowhere to be found. The rumor mill made it sound like it wasn't quite ready to go. As for that new iPhone, Apple is on its S cycle, which means we'll likely see the phone physically identical to last year's iPhone 6, but with some radical hardware changes. The new phone is rumored to include the Force Touch technology included on the Apple Watch and the company's new MacBook and MacBook Pros. The Apple TV is expected to be a complete redesign of the hardware that Apple's been offering unchanged since early 2012. The entire Apple TV experience is largely identical for even longer at this point. If Apple has managed to lock down the content deals it needs to make it stand out, this could be worth a lot of attention in the company's presentation. As for new iPads, it feels like a lot for an event that will already feature the iPhone and Apple TV, but given the slowing down of the iPad business in general, the product category might not quite warrant the headlining status in the October events Apple has held. In recent years, those events also often feature Mac and OS X updates. Whether or not this will be the year we finally see the rumored large-screen iPad Pro remains to be seen. But such a product certainly would take advantage of a lot of a new iPad multitasking features showing up in iOS 9. Fortunately, it seems we won't have to wait long to find out. As usual, The Verge will be there to report all the news as it happens. We've reached out to Apple for a comment on this report and will update if we hear anything else. To the surprise of almost no one who follows Apple, the company is planning to hold a big event early in September to take the ramps off its next iPhone. According to the well-sourced John Patchkowski of BuzzIrond, that event will happen on Wednesday, September 9. iPhones are a shoe-in, as they've been introduced in this time frame every year since 2011. But BuzzIrond also claims we'll see some new iPads as well as the long-awaited new Apple TV. The latter was originally rumored to be introduced at WWDC this year, but it was nowhere to be found. The rumor mill made it sound like it wasn't quite ready to go. As for that new iPhone, Apple is on its S cycle, which means we'll likely see the phone physically identical to last year's iPhone 6, but with some radical hardware changes. The new phone is rumored to include the Force Touch technology included on the Apple Watch and the company's new MacBook and MacBook Pros. The Apple TV is expected to be a complete redesign of the hardware that Apple's been offering unchanged since early 2012. The entire Apple TV experience is largely identical for even longer at this point. If Apple has managed to lock down the content deals it needs to make it stand out, this could be worth a lot of attention in the company's presentation. As for new iPads, it feels like a lot for an event that will already feature the iPhone and Apple TV. But given the slowing down of the iPad business in general, The product category might not quite warrant the headlining status in the October events Apple has held. In recent years, those events also often feature Mac and OS X updates. Whether or not this will be the year we finally see the rumored large-screen iPad Pro remains to be seen, but such a product certainly would take advantage of a lot of a new iPad multitasking features showing up in iOS 9. Fortunately, it seems we won't have to wait long to find out. As usual, The Verge will be there to report all the news as it happens. We've reached out to Apple for a comment on this report and will update if we hear anything else. To the surprise of almost no one who follows Apple, the company is planning to hold a big event early in September to take the ramps off its next Symphony. According to the well-sourced John Patchkowski of BuzzIrond, that event will happen on Wednesday, September 9. Symphonies are a shoe-in, as they've been introduced in this time frame every year since 2011, but BuzzIrond also claims we'll see some new iPads as well as the long-awaited new Apple TV. The latter was originally rumored to be introduced at WWDC this year, but it was nowhere to be found. The rumor mill made it sound like it wasn't quite ready to go. As for that new Symphony, Apple is on its S cycle, which means we'll likely see the phone physically identical to last year's Symphony 6, but with some radical hardware changes. The new phone is rumored to include the Force Touch technology included on the Apple Watch and the company's new MacBook and MacBook Pros. The Apple TV is expected to be a complete redesign of the hardware that Apple's been offering unchanged since early 2012. The entire Apple TV experience is largely identical for even longer at this point. If Apple has managed to lock down the content deals it needs to make it stand out, this could be worth a lot of attention in the company's presentation. As for new iPads, it feels like a lot for an event that will already feature the Symphony and Apple TV, but given the slowing down of the iPad business in general, the product category might not quite warrant the headlining status in the October events Apple has held. In recent years, those events also often feature Mac and OS X updates. Whether or not this will be the year we finally see the rumored large-screen iPad Pro remains to be seen, but such a product certainly would take advantage of a lot of a new iPad multitasking features showing up in iOS 9. Fortunately, it seems we won't have to wait long to find out. As usual, The Verge will be there to report all the news as it happens. We've reached out to Apple for a comment on this report and will update if we hear anything else.